There are many people that still don't understand the seriousness of climate change. As sea temperatures continue to increase, what we'll see is a continual downturn in the amount of coral on these magnificent systems. Global Reef Record is essentially a data bank that we are creating that will be accessible to anybody or any organisation that's interested in the issue of coral reefs worldwide. The ability for people to go virtually diving, to actually experience these reefs firsthand and to understand the problem. We've got these SV2 cameras which look a little like a military torpedo with this strange three-eyed component on the end of them. And of course it's got three cameras that are triggered to take high definition pictures all at once. And the great advantage of that is that you can then stitch it into a 360 degree image, a bit like Street View, as you see on Google. So it's really underwater street view. Well, we started with the Great Barrier Reef in 2012 and basically went to over 30 sites, recorded 150,000 images. This is all about getting that global snapshot that we need for this important ecosystem as we go forward in time. Because as we know, as sea temperatures increase, we're going to see more coral bleaching mortality, there's more stresses from non-climate sources. So it's all about getting that snapshot that we need to understand change. Without it, we're lost. One of the first things to realise about reefs is that they actually occupy a tiny part of the Earth's surface, yet 25% of all marine species live in and around coral reefs, so they're this sort of magnet for biodiversity. And I remember the first time I went and saw, you know, these fish that were the most multicoloured, you know, there's no artist on the planet who could dream these things up, because it is really one of the most magical places on the planet. Clear water, sharks, turtles. So consequently, it's of real concern that they're in steep decline. If we continue along that pathway where, you know, we continue to pump CO2 into the atmosphere, we continue to have heating of the world's oceans, every year will be too warm for corals. And of course, what will happen then is that our current slide, the loss of 50% of those corals after the last 30 years, will continue until we have very, very low amounts of coral on reefs. What we will see is that many parts of the world, if we continue on this journey, will become increasingly vulnerable to insecurity in their food supply, to crowding along coastlines over the last resources left there. You know, they estimate around 300 to 500 million people get their daily food and livelihood from coral reefs alone. For many reasons, reefs are a bit of a storyline about climate and about what we're doing to the oceans. And in many ways, the signal to say we've got to do things differently.